Hi people, alright, it's Tun here. So today I thought it would be fun to share with you guys a typical day of a wedding, alright? So I've been a wedding videographer for about a year now, alright? A wedding photographer for about 4 years. Yeah, 4 years now. And I thought today it would be fun to share with you guys a typical day of a videographer, a wedding videographer, basically. If you're new to this channel, hi, welcome, I'm Tun. I'm a videographer, photographer here in Singapore. And if you guys want to learn about photography, videography stuff, just hit the subscribe button down below and I post out video every week. This is definitely the channel to go to if you want to learn and improve your videography, photography right here. So today I thought it'd be fun to share with you guys what my schedule is like on a full day of wedding. As a videographer, let's start the video, right? So on a typical day, we usually wake up very early around 5 to 6 a.m. give or take, because usually I do Chinese wedding, and in Chinese wedding there are something called a gate crash, and where usually the groom have to come over to the bride house, give or take, if I'm not wrong, around 9 a.m. or it's just a traditional thing, she has to see the bride by 9 a.m. That's why we have to head down to the house usually very early. And once we reach the house, usually the makeup artist will already be there preparing the bride for the day, you know, making her pretty and all. Of course, she's already pretty, she's making her prettier, all right? Anyway, so what we will usually do is we'll kind of greet the bride and we will, you know, start preparing our stuff. And first thing we do is we take videos of the decor. There's a lot of decorations during the day of the wedding. If you guys didn't know, the bride will usually typically have typically it's around 3 to 5 sisters that will be on arriving early and also preparing for the gate crash, because they have to usually prepare the torture for the guys for the brothers, groomsmen to come in and, you know, maybe sometimes eat like a cup of wasabi or whatsoever. We also do videos of the wedding gown and the bride's shoes that day in the morning. The next thing we usually look out for is the timing. One of the bridesmaids is like the best friend of the bride, so usually she will keep track of the time and we'll ask her for usually what time the groom and his brothers will be coming in. So usually they will come in by car. In Singapore, the neighbors or the neighborhood typically understand that a loud honk or constant honking of the cars means it's a wedding day, so we are usually fine with that. So we will bring down usually a kid or the little brother of the bride, and he'll be like carrying like oranges. He'll have to like open the door for the groom. He'll pass the oranges to the groom, then the groom would give hongbao. Okay, then usually the groom will come up and do the gate crash, and he'll get tortured by the bridesmaid, and the groom will usually have to give quite a number of money before he can enter the house. It's the whole idea of the prince slaying the dragon first, then he can, you know, reach Sleeping Beauty. That's just the whole idea. We would also ask the parents to put on the veil for the bride, so the veiling. So that's what we also shoot and cover. That's a very important thing to cover, also the veiling. Once the husband comes, he'll usually read his vows to the bride before he could enter the room. Technically, he'll go inside the room and unveil her, and then usually kiss her, and voila, you know, he completed the task, the morning task, and yay, success. And usually they'll come out and we'll clap for them, you know, all succeeding and stuff. Yeah, usually that's the morning portion. And right afterwards, we'll go to usually the groom's house for tea ceremony, and then the bride's house for tea ceremony. And yeah, technically afterwards, okay, I don't want to be too detailed about it, but usually that's what go down. And usually after we visit both of parents' houses, alright, we will usually take them out for an hour to two of a video shoot outdoors, just so that we could have some content so that we can easily put up together the same day edit. Whew, oh yeah. Yo, I hope you guys are bearing with me as I'm speaking, because I felt that that is a lot. Wow, damn, 10 minutes already. All right. Guys, are you still there? All right. So that's the morning portion. And yeah, that's quite a number of details to follow. But usually, not to worry. If you want to be a wedding videographer, usually we kind of follow the same template. As much as it can be stressful, because the whole idea of, because it's just a one-time thing, you know. Once that moment is done, you know. So as much as it can be stressful, you got to bear in mind that most weddings typically follow the same template. So most of us are well trained and prepared. And like me, I've been doing I don't know how many weddings have I done. I can't even count anymore. But my boss, so I'm under a mentor. That's lucky for me. But I'm under a mentor that guides me throughout the whole wedding. Most of the time, I hope that's how, if you want to be a wedding videographer, that's how you'll be trained. I think you should find a mentor before you solo out yourself. But if you want to solo out yourself, feel free to. But all the best, all right? Anyway, so let me get back to the afternoon session. Usually after the photo shoot, we're done with the morning. Photo also kind of follow the same pattern. But anyway, so after we're done with the video shoot for the outdoor video shoot, all right, we'll usually head to the hotel. If it's a full day wedding, usually how it does is our shifts are usually from 6 a.m. all the way to typically 12 p.m., 12:30 p.m., give or take. Then we'll head down to the hotel, and at the hotel, we will start the same day edit. So usually the banquet at night will start around 7 p.m. mostly 7 p.m., all right? So we usually will be editing from the same day edit from 1 p.m. all the way till the second march in. Usually the couple don't show the same day edit video until the second march in. That's the typical wedding, all right? But of course, you have to, different couple varies. So this is something you have to communicate with the couple, you know. Not every couple is the same, and not every wedding has the same schedule, all right? So bear that in mind, all right? This is something that happens commonly. Usually the same day edit video will be shown right after the second march in, all right? So we'll be given a time slot of around 6 hours to edit the same day video. And during that time, we have to, eat our lunch, we can get to rest. You got to bear in mind that the people that are watching the same day edit video, you know, the client's friends, they're also around the client's age, the marrying age. So they also, if they like your video, okay, the client's friends and family like your video, okay, one of the family members like your video, they'll come to you right after the wedding and ask you for your contacts, you know. So that's how you get more clients, usually by your work of the same day edit and just word of mouth. All right, so bear in mind to keep your same day edit to your best of your ability, because that will make you get more clients. That's how it typically works. All right. So 7 p.m. reach, we'll go down to the banquet area, and usually we will take videos of the decor again. So we like to show clients that the decor, the cake. I love the banquet portion. It's because mostly once the banquet portion means you already got the hard part done, all right, which is the edit, all right. Once you're shooting that second march in, all right, technically you have already submitted the same day edit, all right. For me, at least, when I work solo, usually I'll have already submitted the same day edit before the first march in. Like by 7 p.m. sharp, I'll have already submitted the same day edit. But if you're working in three, usually you can bear to edit all the way before the second march in, because my boss like to put in the first march in the same day edit video just to create that wow factor. Wow, didn't we witness the first march in? How the hell did it end up in the video? You know, it's a very value-added service just to do. Night shift start is usually where the important thing is the first march in and the second march in, which is definitely the favorite part of the day, which I like to do and take, all right? And usually they'll do yamseng. Yamseng is technically, they'll like, they have to shout this word yamseng three times. They'll like, they'll go like yam, like that. And like, they'll usually do it three times. And each tree represent something. It's supposed to represent something, all right? There's also cake cutting. Oh yeah, so cake cutting is important. We also take videos of the cake cutting. And what else? Usually there are games, but on a typical, the most important ones are the first marching, the second marching, cake cutting, the yamseng, the champagne pouring onto the towels. What else? Yeah, mostly that. That's usually the important shots to take. Okay, so that's the typical day of a wedding videographer. Okay, what we usually cover on a full day wedding. And if you guys have already reached this part, and if you guys want to be a wedding videographer, and after hearing all this you guys feel stressed, don't be, all right? It's fine. Like I said, we usually work on a template. So once you do, it's nerve-wracking, of course, at first, because it's someone's special day to cover. But I would say it's so nerve-wracking, that's why you should do it, right? It's one of those things that I feel that every videographer / photographer should try out once in their life to cover a wedding, all right? Because it's really fast-paced, and it's something, you really get to know your gears very well, honestly, because you come to realize that the thing about being a wedding videographer or a photographer is that a lot of things are quite run and gun. Many moments you have to improvise to get that certain shot and cover that shot, all right? So that being said, don't be stressed. If you get an opportunity to cover a wedding, just do it. I think it's a great experience for any wedding videographer or photographer. And yeah, like, don't be afraid to make mistakes. I've covered enough wedding to say that I've done quite a number of mistakes. Also, my first wedding, I think my first solo wedding photography shoot, I kind of messed up the family shot, all right? That was, I didn't even use the flash, all right? I was supposed to use a flash, but I didn't use it. So it's normal to make mistakes. So I would say just do it. Yeah, that's all I have to say for today's video. Thank you guys for watching. I'm Toon, alright? And yeah, thank you guys for watching. I hope this was very insightful for the people, you know, that want to be a wedding videographer or photographer. And if you're just here just because you want to listen to what goes down, then yeah, thank you guys for watching till the end also. And if you're a client or like a person that's about to get married, who just want to know what it's like on a typical wedding day. And yeah, thank you guys for watching as well. Alright, so if you guys reached this part, hope you guys always subscribe to my channel. Alright, don't forget to subscribe and like this video, smash a like, and leave the notification button on. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye. Take care. Peace out. Hi guys, if you didn't know, I have a website, so go check it out, www.yettoon.com.